There's still time to change our plea. I could get you off.
Oh, dude, don't say things like that.
You can pull out if you want to.
Oh, stop that!
Kirk here.
Captain.
I've run a complete megalite survey on the computer.
I'll tell you what you found. Nothing, right?
It's not all bad, Mr. Spock. Who knows? You may be able to beat your next captain at chess. Kirk out.
Chess.
Wait a minute. Butt sex.
Butt sex?
Butt sex requires a lot of lubrication, right? Lubrication. Super, chupa, chupacabras, the goat killer of Mexican folklore. Folklore is stories from the past that are often fictionalized. Fictionalized to heighten drama. Drama student. Students at colleges usually have bicycles. Binary. It's binary code.
Who's having butt sex?
Then Finney's daughter comes in on behalf of Kirk, which Kirk's lawyer finds odd. This could be a story point that leads somewhere. But it doesn't. It really leads nowhere. And so McCoy finds Mr. Spock busy playing chess. Wow, I guess World of Warcraft must be lagging today, huh?
You're about to lop off the captain's professional head, and you're sitting here playing chess with a computer.
That is true.
Mr. Spock, you're the most cold-blooded man I've ever known.
Why, thank you, Doctor.
I love the fact that my internal temperature is generated by the ambient heat of my surroundings rather than endothermically generated. Thank you, Doctor.
I've just won my fourth game.
That's impossible.
That is why you fail.
So Spock beats the computer four times in a row, which proves that the computer has been tampered with. Okay, so theoretically, yes, this would prove the computer had been altered. Unless Spock, you know, changed his strategies or improved as a player. It doesn't speak well for Spock, does it? Besides that, aren't there simpler and, you know, less time-consuming ways to prove the computer's been altered with? Keystroke analysis? Check the history? Oh, wait. Kirk probably clears that out all the time, doesn't he?
Transporter room standby. We're beaming down.
This could easily have been an episode of JAG. And that includes the pacing of the show, too.
Sir, the prosecution rests.
Counsel for the defense.
I move for a bad court thingy.
You mean a mistrial?
Yeah.
Sir, the defense rests.
So Kirk's lawyer suddenly learns about this evidence after he's rested the case. But wait, he rested the case. What does this mean? Time for a weepy speech about human rights.
I speak of rights. A machine has none. A man must.
So if he claims machines have no rights, does this guy equal this guy?
Your response is emotional and irrational.
Irrational?
You are endowing data with human characteristics because it looks human, but it is not. If it were a box on wheels, I would not be facing this opposition.
Puts a new spin on it. And so they agree to go back to the Enterprise to continue, because we need to strike this set for the next episode. And so back on board, Mr. Spock tells his story. Again. And again. So we find out that only Kirk, Spock, or Finney could have reprogrammed the computer. Out of 430 people, only 3 could have done it. Okay, I'll go with it. It's badly run, but Kirk's running it, so I'll go with that. And so the lawyer suggests that Finney faked his death. That's more interesting than more procedure. So they go to the bridge, clear the ship, and partake in the most logical way to prove that someone's hiding on board. Internal sensors? No. Some sort of a heat analysis? No. Let's turn all the ship microphones way up and listen for heartbeats.
All right, Mr. Spock.
Black Eyed Peas music! Shut it off! Shut it off! And then McCoy goes around with a wireless microphone to shut off the heartbeat sounds of everyone else. Star Trek! And yet, after everything, there's one heartbeat left. Well, yeah, there's not enough time left for there not being one heartbeat left. If you follow.
Finney.
Localize that.
B-deck. In or near engineering.
Seal off B-deck, sections 18Y through 23D.
Acknowledged.
Commodore, this is my problem. I would appreciate it if no one left the bridge.
So, the Enterprise's orbit is decaying, and no one can get off the ship, and Kirk decides to hunt Finney down alone, because this is him. Mano a mano. Oh, just end the show. Meanwhile, the lawyer has brought Finney's daughter back on board. Human shields! It's the Starfleet way!
Hello, Captain.
I'm Mr. Red.
Officers and gentlemen, captains all, except for Finney and his one stick.
And the subsequent series of violations of policy, reprogramming of computers, attempted murders and frame-ups, you know, if you count those little trifling things.
Mr. Spock, we're running out of time.
Gentlemen, if you'll please hurry to the transporter.
Mr. Spock, the court has not yet reached a verdict. We will hear this witness out.
Oh, yes. I must continue to watch this, even when the ship is plummeting into the atmosphere. Well, yeah, it's the only interesting part of the show.
You can be helped. But if you kill all those people...
Why shouldn't I?
They killed me, didn't they? It's a fair trade.
Is Jamie included in that deal?
What do you mean?
She's on board by now.
So, Kirk uses his hostage to goad Finney into fighting and promptly whoops his butt. Not only that, but Kirk can now single-handedly fix the ship. And he does it with a voiceover, because we're running out of time. Maybe if we hadn't spent the first act telling the story again and 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 again, we wouldn't have to rush the third act. George Lucas. Excuse me, sorry about that. So Kirk fixes the ship and the prosecution drops all charges. And we're right back where we began.
Casey Smith!
Your Honor, do I still get paid?
I didn't have much of a chance to thank him.
He's busy on a case. He's defending Ben Fimmick.
Oh, great! Now the lawyer's defending Finney, the man we know is guilty. So he's Johnny Cochran.
Do you think it would cause a complete breakdown of discipline if a lowly lieutenant kissed a starship captain on the bridge of his ship?
But when's it my turn? Oh my. And so that's court-martial. Is it good? No. Does it have good moments? One or two. Does that make a good episode? Again, no. So, of course, decide for yourself, but as for me, I'm calling court-martial POS TOS.